Couch with Koel.
He had a major hand in India's World Cup victory, but cricket is only his second choice. Gautam Gambhir would have much rather joined the army, perhaps because he is the biggest fan of revolutionary Bhagat Singh. On the pitch, he's aggressive, intense and serious. Off the pitch, shy and aloof. And in spite of being one of the highest run scorers, doesn't quite get the attention that some of the bad boys do. Does this even bother him? We're about to find out. Hello and welcome, Gautam Gambhir. Thank you very much for coming on my couch. You know, I've been watching you play, and it seems that the bigger the match, the better your performance is. Does the pressure have anything to do with this?
Well, obviously, I think I've always believed that if you really want to be recognized and if you really want to make a contribution in the team, it is those matches where you need to make it count. And I've always played my cricket in that way. I've never got anything that easily because the kind of experiences I've had in the past from under 14 days to till the time I made a permanent place in the Indian team, I had to really struggle a lot to get my place in the Indian team. So I think I was always under pressure. So that could be one reason why I always feel that the more I can get the best out of me.
And this recent World Cup, people say that, you know, the pressure made them do all kinds of things. Like Dhoni says he couldn't eat. He would see the food and he couldn't eat. Some people talked about they couldn't sleep. What did it do to you, this pressure?
Look, I had a very big motivation getting into this World Cup because in 2007 when I was dropped, that was the lowest point of my cricketing career. And I thoroughly believed that I should have been part of 2007 World Cup team as well. So that was the lowest moment in my life. So this was my first 50-over World Cup. So I wanted to make it count. And I wanted to make a big statement, not to the people or anyone, just to myself, that when I was dropped in 2007, can I make a big contribution in this World Cup, which is going to be my first World Cup. So it couldn't have got better being the highest run getter in the final and ended up being on the winning side.
People from your team have told me that you drove people crazy by telling them how much you wanted to score a century in the World Cup. I mean, 97, and I watched you, my heart bled for you. I mean, you know, I was like, wow, you've done so well. But what were your thoughts firstly at that moment when you got out at 97?
Look, one motivation which I had was during the World Cup was when Ian Chappell wrote an article on me that I should be dropped from the playing 11. I think that really motivated me, to be very honest. And another motivation which I already have mentioned is that I was dropped in 2007. So there were a lot of motivation for me to getting into this World Cup. And obviously, there couldn't have been any bigger stage than being the World Cup final. And if I could have scored my first World Cup century, it would have been icing on the cake.
Did you think you psyched yourself out by going like, I want to score a century,
I would have gone in future as well. Because when I was in 97, I had nothing in my mind. I just wanted to keep playing. Suddenly, when I reached 97, I thought that's just 3 runs away. So my mind maybe would have gone into the future, and that is not a great thing because suddenly there was a rush of blood. But I still feel if you see the positive side of it, I would have scored 100 and India would have ended up being on the losing side. It wouldn't have given me any happiness. Scoring 97 and being on the winning side is far more special than scoring 100.
So personal records, you don't mind sacrificing for the greater good of the team?
I think there wouldn't have been a greater cause than winning the World Cup for the country. And if you can contribute in that... in that thing, I think there's nothing better.
But let me say this, if you had scored your 100 at that time, then you would have been the man of the match and not Dhoni. And perhaps your entire career would have changed from that moment onwards, just in terms of the attention that you would have got. Do you ever think of that?
Well, obviously, when I got out in 97, the first thing that came in my mind was that I'm going to regret these 3 runs for the rest of my life. Not because, I would get a man of the match in the World Cup final, nothing of that sort. Maybe it's just that it would have been a self-satisfaction that scoring a World Cup final 100, no Indian has done it, and being on the winning side would have been icing on the cake. But there are certain things, it was my own mistake, I totally accept that. But being on the winning side is far more special than scoring 100.
Now, you are one of the cricketers who is great on the pitch, but off the pitch, we never hear of you. Okay, you're very shy, you're very aloof. Would you say that that's right?
Not really. I think this is...
It's a myth?
It's a myth, totally a myth.
Come on, break it then. Let's see the...
Well, I've got my own ways of relaxing. I've got my own ways of making myself feel happy. And maybe there are a lot of people who like partying and going out a lot. Maybe for me, being with family, being with close people and... maybe going out with those close people is all that matters. And whatever gives me happiness is what gives me happiness. I have never tried doing things what doesn't make me happy. Everyone is different, and this is how I've always been. So
is fame important to you? Because a lot of your other colleagues have a lot more fame than you do. You know, even though you're one of the highest run scorers, you're not someone who everyone flocks to immediately. If you're working with a UV, then they'll probably go to him. Do you find that? Does that bug you?
Not really. I think for me, playing for India is a responsibility. I don't play to seek attention. I play for the country. I play to win games for the country. Maybe in that case, if I don't get attention, it's fair enough, because my objective of playing for country and my objective of playing cricket is very different to maybe what other people feel. Because for me, it's a responsibility. It's an honor, and I have the responsibility of the entire country on my shoulder.
After India won the semi-finals in the World Cup with India-Pakistan, you said something which actually was quite inflammatory. You said, you know, this is our revenge for what they did to us in 2006-11.
Never. I think it's just been misquoted.
What did you say?
I never said. I just said that if we end up winning the World Cup, or if we end up winning the semi-final, that will be for the victims of 2006-11. And it was just my personal decision. I never said it's going to be revenge for 2006-11. And at the same time, I said that if we end up winning the World Cup, it will be for the Jawans. So
you didn't say it because it's been quoted everywhere.
Yeah, absolutely. It was misquoted because I heard Shahid Afridi commenting on that and all that stuff, which was all misquoted, because it was just a normal thing I said, that if we end up winning the World Cup or winning the semi-final, it will be for the victims of 2006-11. There was nothing wrong in saying what I felt like.
Now, anyone who knows you talks about you as a nationalist, you know, like you've just turned around and said your country is really important. Your first choice of job or career would have been the army. But then does it really, really get under your skin when people have brought up this whole debate about club versus country, especially for someone like you, where it's very clear that, you know, you believe in the good of the country?
It really shocked me to be honest, because country is something which is always close to me and will always stay close to me. I don't want to poop people by saying something or giving interviews by saying, oh, you know what, country is the most important thing to me. You want to go out there and give your 100% irrespective of what team you play for, because being a professional cricketer, you want to win games. And as when people were discussing that I shouldn't have played that game for KKR, I think being the captain of KKR, it was my moral responsibility to play that game, and the importance of that game was such that I couldn't have let go that game. So
winning is everything for you, right?
Absolutely.
I mean, you're not one of those people who are saying, I love it for the love of it and for the fun of it. If you're not winning, it's not good enough.
Honestly, cricket is no more, to be honest, give you 100% and results doesn't matter, all that stuff. Ultimately, there are two teams that are playing, and you go out there to win. You don't go out there to compete. So for me, there's only one way of giving happiness and bringing happiness is go out there, give you 100% and win.
Now, you are a big fan of Bhagat Singh. What does he mean to you, and why are you a fan?
Look, when I was a young kid, I think the first movie which I saw was Shaheed, which was made by Manoj Kumar. And since then, I think the only idol which I had and the only person who I want to know more about and the only book which I've read till now is about Bhagat Singh. There's no one I want to know about. There's no one who I idolize. There's only one person. Maybe because the thing which he's done at the age of 23, the kind of passion he had and the kind of patriotism he had, I think the more I read about him, the more I become his fan. So it's just that he's been my inspiration and there's no one else.
And you wanted to join the army?
Yeah, because I think...
That's your first love.
I still want to join the army.
Why?
For me, the actual heroes in this country are the defense forces, the soldiers and the Jawans who are standing on the border. Those are the actual heroes. I think they don't get the same credit what other people get. They don't get the same recognition. So for me, they are the people.
What have you done for them now that you are in a position where you could do something?
Anything.
What have you done?
I haven't started anything, to be honest. I definitely in future want to do something for the families of the people who've lost their lives for this country, because they are the actual heroes and they deserve every bit of it.
Why didn't you join the army?
Very unlucky.
Very unlucky.
That I didn't join the army because that's...
He says, being part of the winning squad of India, very unlucky that he didn't join the army. Lucky for us.
I'll be honest, given an opportunity, even now, I would still join the army because that still is my first love.
So why didn't you? I want to understand this. Did you have family pressure?
Look, never. I think my family was very supportive. They never even forced me to play cricket. They never forced me in anything. I genuinely had decided that if I go after school, I would definitely join the army. But then I played Ranji Trophy in 12th. And everyone told me, look, you're so close to playing for India. And if you do well in Ranji Trophy, you would definitely get selected for India. Though that was not a guarantee to be picked for India, but I was still, Ranji Trophy is still a very big thing. It's So that was the only reason I thought that, look, what people are saying is also very correct, that at least still if I end up playing for India, I'll still do something for the country. So that was the reason I still ended up playing cricket.
You know, your colleagues from Delhi and from Ranji Trophy times, they say that, you know, you're always very serious in the dressing room, that the one thing, one muscle that he doesn't use is the smile muscle. But now I'm sitting opposite you, you're smiling a lot. So can you just dispel this myth and just smile for us in camera, the biggest, brightest smile before we go for a break? There we have it. Gotti with the smile. He's born, brought up Delhi, but says he's no longer a Delhi boy, but actually his heart and soul belongs to Calcutta. Was this just survival for KKR?
No. I think the kind of person I am, and I totally believe in it. Whatever I say, I mean it. Because when I was picked for KKR, I had decided that time that I'm going to give everything possible for KKR and for the people of Calcutta. Because the kind of, I think whatever they've got in first 3 years, they didn't get too much of happiness because KKR had not done well in the first 3 years. So it was my total commitment for KKR, and I wanted to give happiness to the people of Calcutta. And
were you also angry that Delhi didn't retain you?
Not at all. I think I'm not someone who gets angry in these things. When I was picked for KKR...
Only in the most expensive player, it obviously worked in your favour.
Well, for me, playing for KKR and leading the KKR was far more important than being the highest paid cricketer, because...
But it doesn't hurt. The money doesn't hurt.
Doesn't hurt, but then with money comes responsibility as well. If KKR would have invested so much in me, with that, they must have seen something in me, and there was a lot of responsibility on me as well. If people think that it's the captain or the coach which makes the great team, I never believe in it. It's the team. Those are great. There are no great captains and no great coaches. There are only great teams.
There are no great captains, you'd say that Dhoni is not a great captain then?
No, I think for me, Dhoni is a very good captain, but I don't believe in the staff. There are no great captains and there are no great coaches. It's the team that make them great, because one or two individuals can never win the game.
Okay, let's talk about your personal life a little bit. You're recently engaged.
I think it's a rumor. I think the
you're not engaged.
No, it's
so. Who is Natasha Jain?
Well, I think let's not discuss about this, and I want to just keep it pretty.
Are you in love or not?
I'm in love. I think it's a big question. I'm not in love.
You're not in love. Have you ever been in love? You never had a girlfriend. Listen, you're a fellow modernite, okay?
So it's not important to have a girlfriend being modernite.
No, but modern school, you know, these things were kind of part and parcel of growing up, right? So you were too busy playing cricket?
All the time. I was too busy playing cricket, and I was only playing cricket in school.
So you've had no romance in your life?
No, I hardly had time for all these things, because...
The other men don't seem to, you know...
Those are
your other cricketers don't... seem to say that they're too busy for romance. They have time, they make time.
And that's their way of, I think, dealing with life. And for me, I think I was...
You know what will happen, if you just keep playing, then suddenly you look around and you'll be 40 and alone.
No, that won't happen, to be honest.
So seriously, you've had no girlfriends?
Well, I've had friends, to be honest. And if you ask me about a steady relationship in the past, never had any, because I was always busy playing cricket. I was always away, away and away. Being a modernite, obviously, you end up having a lot of friends, but there never was into the steady relationship.
What kind of girl would steal Gotham's heart away?
Oh, that's a good, big question.
It is a big question.
Yeah, that what kind of a girl I would... Look, someone who would understand the kind of schedule we have, which is very important, because there will be time when you will always be away from her, and there will be time you would not be able to give so much of time to her as a normal person would. And the kind of pressures being an Indian cricketer go through, because the kind of responsibility and the kind of pressures you go through and the kind of expectation people have from you, especially now being the world champion, will be something which she really needs to deal with. And so there are a lot of things which the girl might have to sacrifice, and because for us it's very difficult to give time.
So as long as the girl understands that cricket is first love and she is second love, then she's okay.
Absolutely.
So you don't want any other traits?
So the thing is, my first love still remains Army, the second love is cricket, and she might be the third one.
That's terrible. Poor girl, who's going to be going out with you or marry you if you
imagine.
Say this?
So she's got to be only third in the list.
That's terrible. But there must be some features that you like in a girl, like she must be soft-spoken, or she must be bright, or she must be athletic, or she must be fat or thin, or some traits. You have female fans, let them be slightly encouraged.
Well, obviously, soft-spoken is something which is very important, and someone who's had a good upbringing, and someone who's pretty chilled out as well, and doesn't take life that hard, because for me, it's always been very hard because the kind of responsibility I have and the kind of experiences I've had. So I want someone who's just right opposite, completely opposite. So that
so chilled out,
absolutely yeah. Sure, and which can be fun to be with. So these are small things.
So you're 29 now. Do you think marriage anywhere in the near future or?
Obviously marriage will happen soon or whenever I decide to, because first of all, for that I really need to find time. I really need to have time for that as well, because the kind of cricket you're playing and the amount of cricket you're playing, you would always be away. So, and then finding the right person as well, which is very important. So,
would you settle for someone that your parents, perhaps your grandparents found for you, or would you like to find your own girl?
So it depends, to be honest. I think they would be pretty open with everything, whether it's me finding or them finding. And it's just the important thing is how much I get along with the other person is all that matters to them and for me as well. And someone who I said that can understand
cricket.
No, she doesn't need to understand cricket, to be honest. She just needs to understand that there will be times where I would not be able to give so much of time to her as well.
People here who want to ask you a question.
Hi Gautam, how are you?
All good.
I have a question for you. Gray was a great coach for the Indian team and now he's no more with the Indian team. Do you think that his absence with the Indian team will affect the performance in the England too?
Look, I think he's done a great job for us in the last 3 years, and obviously we had a great understanding with him. He's been fantastic. He's been a great man manager. I think obviously we would miss him because the kind of effort he's put in the team. But then, as I said, that life moves on, and to be honest, it's the passion of the players which ends up the performance which you've given. It's not the coaches or one or two people in the setup. I think it's the team which goes on the park. If they have the passion to do well, they will still do well in the future.
We hear no stories about your nightlife like Yuvraj and other players. Are you happy with locker room boys, or you swing both ways, or is it you don't have any...
Like that's the way I am, to be honest, and that's the way I don't want to change by seeing someone else what they do, because what I want to do is what I want to do. And as you said about my nightlife, I think I'm not a night person, to be honest, and I'm someone who would have other ways of unwinding myself and who would want to do a different thing which makes me happy, rather than if I don't like nightlife, if I don't like going to a nightclub, I would rather not force myself to go there. And there are people, and there's nothing wrong in going, to be honest. I'm very straightforward that if someone goes, there's nothing wrong in it as well. People should not, or someone should not make a lot of hue and cry that they party a lot and they do this, they should not party. Look, it's their personal thing. For me, what makes me happy is what I want to do. What makes other people happy is what they should do.
Thank you.
Okay, we're going to play a little game now. It's called Couch Confession, and you have to answer without thinking. Couch Confession. What are your dreams made of?
Doing something for the society.
What are your nightmares made of?
Not playing cricket or retiring from cricket.
When and where were you the happiest?
With family at home.
I thought you were going to say the World Cup moment, but that's an interesting answer. The last time you cried and why?
I don't remember the last time I cried because I'm not someone who shows a lot of emotions. The last time I was very emotional was when I watched Tare Zameen.
So you do cry? Oh, because we don't see any emotion on the pitch at all.
Look, as I said, that I hardly cry, but the last time I got really emotional was when I watched that movie.
What angers you on the pitch? Because when we see you, you look like you're playing an angry game. Does that help you?
Look, I don't get angry. It's just the passion for the... It's just the will to win is something which sometimes makes me aggressive. And it's the passion to win games for the country is all. It's never that I take all those rivalries personally. On the field, whatever happens, I just keep it till there, because it's just that you want to go out there and win the game, getting close to each other.
Who would you say you're closest to in the team?
I can't mention one, but I think there are a lot of guys who I'm really close to. I think
someone who would you get on best with? Have the most fun with?
Someone like Viru, because we really got along well, and we do get along well because we open the batting. We play. We used to play for Delhi Daredevils. We used to play for ONGC. So we spend a lot of time with each other. Someone like Ishan, because he's from Delhi. And Yuvi is a very good friend, and Munaf is a good friend, and Amit as well. There's a lot of guys, but if you
and
ask...
And who do you keep a distance from, out of either respect or just that you're different, or who do you keep your,
No one. I think, why do you want to keep distance? It's just that...
I don't know.
But yeah, out of respect, if you ask me, there's Sachin is someone who's, I think, who's been the legend of the game. So he's someone who you always want to have that respect for, and he earns that respect automatically.
If you had 5 days to live, what would you do?
Join the army. Because that still is my first love.
It's army, cricket, then everything
then
else,
everything.
Right? Okay. Who would you like to be stuck in a lift?
Preeti Zinta.
And you've never been stuck in a lift with her?
Never. Because that's someone I've always, I think I've interacted with her, but she's someone who has a great knowledge about a lot of things in a way that she's really passionate about things, what she does, even when it's about IPL or about Kings 11 or whatever she does. I think someone.
And she's an army kid and she's a cricketer, cricketing fan and owns a team. Preeti Zinta, are you listening? What has been the biggest temptation that you've either given into or really had to control yourself to not give in?
Honestly, I'm a very lazy guy. There are times when I just don't want to do anything. If I come back home, I just hate doing anything. I'm very lazy. So there are times when I just don't feel like doing anything, but there are times when I have to push myself. Look, I have to go to the gym, which has just become necessary, or I really have to push myself.
So right
back.
Now, it's your nightmare that I've put you in here,
absolutely.
Right?
I think you've chosen the wrong location, to be honest, because this is something which I normally hate coming to, but then it's my professional thing which forces me.
So are you feeling guilty sitting here looking
really
at people working out? Let's see your muscles. Do you have?
I don't have any. See this.
Come here, let me see. I have bigger muscles than you.
Does this show that I hardly go to the gym?
How would you like to be remembered?
As someone, I think people should respect me as a human being than as a cricketer, because I think cricket is something which will end one day, maybe next 4 years, 5 years, who knows, and maybe next 1 year. If I can earn their respect as a person, I mean, I've achieved a lot in everything, because there are a lot many times I don't want people to say that after finishing cricket, oh, thank God that he's gone, that he was a useless human being, though he might be a very good cricketer, but a useless human being. I think I want it the other way around. If people can respect me as a human being, I've earned everything in life.
Well, I can tell you one thing, that you are very earnest and you do deserve the respect. So thank you very much.
Pleasure.
And all the best.
Thank you.
Log on to headlinestoday.in or follow my tweets at Koel's Couch. On the Couch with Koel. On the Couch with Koel.